Okay, follow me here. We pull our sleeves down before touching any door handle. We do intricate balancing acts on one foot to flush a public toilet with the other. But hotel rooms are supposed to be the epitome of cleanliness. Yeah, I wouldn't count on it. These room items are much dirtier than you think. 1. The hairdryer. Surprisingly, that tiny hairdryer is one of the biggest sources of germs in the whole room. First, everyone touches it. And the moist environment that's created after you take a shower, plus the heat from the hairdryer, equals a nasty breeding ground for all those bacteria to multiply. Hotel staff are required to disinfect the obvious stuff in the bathroom, like the toilet and sink. But more obscure items, that hairdryer, gets cleaned less often. In a study done by ABC, items from 9 different hotel rooms were swabbed, and the hairdryer always came back the dirtiest. So, just keep that in the back of your mind for the rest of this list. The hairdryer is dirtier than… Number 2. The carpet. Travelers walk around the whole city, the subway, public bathrooms. Do you think they all take their shoes off when they get back to the room? If only. What's worse, hotel carpets aren't shampooed as often as you would expect or hope. Cleaning staff will quickly run a vacuum to pick up debris, but that's about it. Shampooing services are expensive, so hotels save money by deep cleaning the carpets less often. In the end, those floors are left to collect everyone's hair, flaked off skin, and bacteria from shoes and feet. You. Number 3. Lamp switches. They're some of the most touched things in the room, especially the lamp switches by your bed. Staff may wipe the surface of the bedside table, but this is yet one more thing that'll easily get overlooked. The University of Houston conducted a contamination study on hotel rooms, and the lamp switches were filthy. Number 4. Bathroom countertops. Sure, hotel staff wipe them down and remove any obvious grub, but this is way different from getting properly disinfected. Even in 4-star hotels, scientists have found that the bathroom counters contain the most CFU, or colony-forming units, of bacteria. Think twice about laying your personal hygiene items on that counter, especially anything that goes in your mouth, like your toothbrush or retainer. 5. TV remotes. I mean, how many times do you disinfect your own remotes at home? Exactly! Hotel staff are trying to clean rooms quickly to get them ready for the next guest, so the TV remotes are maybe given a quick wipe down. Be a savvy traveler and always pack disinfecting wipes. 6. Drinking glasses. Yeah, they may look spot-free and crystal clear from a distance, but next time you check into a hotel room, look at the drinking glasses a little closer. You might want to rethink using them for your nighttime water. The cleaners don't have dish soap on their carts, so the glasses usually get a quick rinse with hot water. Some have admitted to using shampoo or even furniture polish to remove any spots. 7. The bedspread. After a long flight, all you want to do is fall on the bed. Well, how do you feel about sharing it with some bacteria? Studies done by the University of Arizona show that the bedspread is among the top 11 dirtiest things in your room. Aren't you just getting excited about going on vacation? Yeah! Number 8. Throw pillows. Yes, those little decorative pillows on the bed don't look so cute under a microscope. Think of it this way. What do you do with throw pillows when you're getting ready for bed? Yeah, you throw them somewhere. If you're exhausted or simply flailing around in your sleep, you might just scoot them off and onto the floor. You know, the one covered in hair and foot fungus? Of course, you might feel tempted to carefully set them on the couch for the night, but… Number 9. The sofa. It's grimy as well! It collects germs from people's suitcases, shoes, and anything else guests might toss on it. And just like those throw pillows, the couch doesn't get shampooed or steamed very often. It might sound like cleaners aren't doing their jobs, but try to see it from their perspective. Most have 15 to 30 rooms to clean every single day and only 8 hours to do it. It takes me an entire weekend to clean the 7 rooms in my house. 10. The curtains. Now, you wouldn't think the curtains get touched that often, But lots of people like to throw them open first thing in the morning and close them last thing before bed. That's enough for them to build up some bacteria. Plus, dust and hair have a habit of flying around the room. Researchers found that in some 3-star hotels, the drapes only got a mere dusting just once a month. Now, since we're on the topic of curtains… 11. The shower curtain. The steamy environment makes the bathroom ideal real estate for bacteria and mildew. Yes, the cleaning staff make sure to disinfect the tub and toilet, but the shower curtain, with all those folds for germs to hide? Some 3-star hotels clean it just once a month as well. 12. The phone. If you want to call the front desk or order room service, you might want to grab an antibacterial wipe first. Since we use our cell phones for so much nowadays, hotel staff aren't making the phone in your room their first cleaning priority. 13. The coffee maker. If they aren't cleaned regularly with vinegar as they should be, coffee makers can become disgusting very quickly. If you decide you want to sleep in, skip the hotel breakfast, and have your cup of Java in your room, you're putting yourself at risk by drinking a hot cup of bacteria-laden coffee. Those machines don't get a vinegar rinsing very often. 14. The desk. Studies show that desks in hotel rooms are just wiped down, not disinfected. The result? Swabs done show a plethora of contagious respiratory viruses on that handy writing surface. It's no wonder travelers get the cold and flu so often. 15. Faucets. Now, some hotels have been known to wipe down the bathroom counter and faucets with the same cloth they use to clean the toilets. This can give you some gnarly gastrointestinal problems, which is a fancy word for a seriously bad stomach ache. 16. The tap water. It's filthy, so don't drink it. The tap is connected to a municipal water source, especially if you're in a big city. This kind of water can carry lead, E. coli, and chlorine. To be safe, you might want to bring your own water bottles or a purifier. 17. The ice bucket. Trust me, it hasn't only been used to hold ice. Remember that stomach virus hanging out on the bathroom counter? I'll let you put two and two together. Couple that with minimal cleaning, and you've got yourself a big problem when you drop a few ice cubes into your drink. Just skip the ice. 18. Your room key. If touching anything else on this list can be avoided, your key isn't one of them. You need it to get into your filthy, germ-infested room. Well, the keys themselves are never disinfected, and they should be. Think about how many times your room key has changed hands. In fact, researchers say that your room key is just as dirty and germy as money. Better grab a wet wipe. 19. The mattress. Now, I'm not talking about busting out a black light and looking for drool stains, although that's not a bad idea. Nope, it's all about bed bugs, and hotels can be teeming with them. Bed bugs carry over 40 disease-causing bacteria. They're also tough to get rid of once you bring them back home from your hotel room. Besides the mattress, check the box spring and behind the headboard for signs of these little buggers. 20. The air itself. The air in hotel rooms tends to be quite stale. If you're allergic to things like dander, mildew, and mold, you might be in for a rough stay. Even if you don't have allergies, stale air is unhealthy because it piggybacks irritants and bacteria into the body. Make all the tinfoil hat jokes you want. I wouldn't want to breathe that stuff in or touch absolutely anything in a hotel room. Better yet, think I'll never leave my house again. Sounds to me like a great idea to work hard on getting your immune system in tip-top shape so you can relax and enjoy your vacation in paradise. Hey, if you learned something new today, then give this video a like and share it with a friend. Here are some other fun and informative videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right. And remember, stay on the bright side of life.